First of all, happy Diwali. Let's make it happier by understanding how to clean this data effectively and quickly. First, what is the problem with the data? For convenience, I've given our famous 10 item checklist. If all the 10 items are okay, that means data is clean. So does every column have a heading? Yes. No blank heading? Okay. No duplicate heading? Fine. Merge cells? Yes. These are merged cells and they're an absolute no-no. We must unmerge the cells, but then we have another problem. We have one meaning in one column. Type, page, publication? Yes. One column, one meaning. Date column, two meanings. There's category as well as date. That's a bad idea. Those categories deserve to have a separate column on their own. So we'll see how to use Power Query to clean this data. The first step is to insert a table. Yes, our table does have a header. It's always better to make sure the correct range is selected. Table design and table one is the default name. Once you create a table, all merged sales are automatically unmerged. Doesn't even ask you. The problem is, I want these categories to have their own column, and all that we are not going to do manually in Excel. We are going to do it in Power Query. So close this file, blank new file, and now we will import data from the other file. And while importing it, we will clean it up. So go to data, get data from file Excel and choose that file. We have one table and one sheet. Of course, we never touch sheets. Tables are always good. We don't want to load it as it is. We want to clean it up. So transform. Now our best friend Power Query will open. It'll show you all the columns. In case you don't see this valid error empty, go to the View tab and choose Column Quality. It's a good way of quickly knowing overall what is there in the column. We are interested in splitting this column into two. I want a separate column for category where the word finance, sports, etc. comes. We have to apply some logic. Instead of applying logic on this column, let's look at the publication column. Wherever there is null or empty, I want whatever is written in the date column to be picked up and added in a new column. If publication is not empty, then I don't want anything. It should be left alone. That's called conditional column. So go to add column, conditional column. We'll give category as the name. The condition is based on publication column. And we want to check, does it have null? If it does have null, then I want data from the date column. I don't want to put a value there. That will get hard coded. I want to say select a column. Now I get a column drop down and date. And if none of this is happening, then anyway, it is empty. When you click OK, it picked up correctly finance, sports and so on. Now you want to fill it up. I don't want to do it manually. So right click on the column name. We want to fill, so yes, fill downwards and job is done. Now there's only one thing left. These rows, finance, sports are still alive. And in the other columns, they're anyway empty. We want to get rid of those rows completely. How do we do that? Well, open any of these drop downs and say get rid of nulls. That's one way of doing it. Or you could have gone to the cell, right click, text filter does not equal. And that's exactly how we wanted the data. The last step always is to manage the data types. Look at the data type. The name of the column is date, but the data type is undetermined. How do you know that? When you go to the home tab, data type any. That means it has not been checked, detected, understood. I don't want to do data type checking column by column. So I'm going to say Control A, select all, go to the transform tab, and let Power Query figure out the data types. This is faster, but not always accurate. You may still want to override. So after it has done automatic detection of data type, go to each column and check. This date, okay. Text, number, text, text. And finally, we are ready to import the data. Go to the Home tab, never click on the upper part. Always close and load too, so that we can consciously choose the way in which we are going to import the data. What if I want a pivot table? I don't want raw data, directly pivot table possible. But right now for demo purpose, I'm going to import it as table. So that's how you clean up data with merged rows. I've opened the original file and let's add some rows there. Save this file, close this file. Our clean version is still open. Right click and refresh. and everything should work exactly as expected. And that's the power of Power Query. The bigger learning here is whatever may be the cleanup requirement, first understand exactly what is to be cleaned up and do not do it manually. Always use Power Query. If you have a situation and you don't know how to do it, put it in comments. I'll be happy to help you. In fact, when you like, share, subscribe, put comments, all that makes YouTube understand that this video is useful, and then it is going to show it to millions of other people who also have the same problem. And that's how you and me can make the world a happier and more efficient place. So that's it for now. Thank you.